Hi everyone, this is Jason here from Nathaniel, and in this lesson, as part of our series on how to make arpeggios sound unique and develop an original flavor, we are going to look at Latin rhythms and more specifically the claves, which are sort of the backbone of Latin music and all things groovy, if you will. So I'm going to introduce you to a few Latin rhythms. I've also done videos on these things. We will link them up in the description. We've talked about tresillo. We've talked about a lot of these things before, but not with arpeggios. So I'm now going to look at all these rhythms with arpeggios. But if you'd like additional learning, do check out our links in the description. And before I get started, very quickly, if you haven't already, please subscribe to our channel, turn on the bell icon for notifications, and let's go. Okay, so the same chords as what we've been doing in our series: E minor, G major, D major, and A major. Okay, I'm using inversions in order to navigate them better and also to create a better sound and a better cohesive vibe when I play the arpeggios. And I'm also playing them using inversions, which makes it very easy to shift and also very nice on the ear. Some nice voicing, right? So a common way to play these chords would end up being, right, which I've talked about in an earlier introductory video on these arpeggios. Or maybe you can start from the top, right? So these are nice, these sound awesome, but they don't sound unique, okay? So what we're going to try to do in this lesson is to use the clave hit points, which are at all the interesting beats and subdivisions, to kind of develop a very groovy sounding arpeggio, if you will, okay? So the first rhythm which I'd like you to try out and practice with me is what we call as the tresillo, okay? The tresillo, we've written it down there, so check that out. And what happens there is you have the hit points at 1E and 2E and a. So it's a 2-beat rhythm if you divide the beat by 4. So you need to first count your 16th notes. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E. So a great way to start counting the 16th notes would end up being with accents. You can go 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E. I'm accenting all the downbeats. So first practice this. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E. Now try to practice the E. 1E, 2E, E, 4E, and 1E, 2E, 3E, and 4E, and 1. In other words, I'm just saying it a bit louder. Now the N. 1E, and 2E, and 3E, and 4E, and 1E, and 2. Sounds a bit funny, but you have to do it. 1E, and 2E, and 3E, and 4E, and now my favorite, the Us. 1E and 2E and 3E and 4E and 1E and 2E and 3E. So these interesting Latin rhythms and generally any groovy dance rhythm is going to end up needing all of these subdivisions. You need to divide the beat generally by 4. So that's 1E and a. You have 16 spots to fill in a bar of 4. And you need to give gaps. Playing something like dubba 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 or Niana may be tough on your fingers, but it's very easy on the mind because your mind doesn't have to remove anything and it doesn't have to track the way beats are flowing one after the other. It's just ongoing and repetitive in a ladder-like approach. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da, right? So we are not, our intention by dividing the beat by 4 is not to play fast, but to have more options to express our notes on our respective arpeggio which we are going to play, okay? So the tresillo is basically ta, 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 ta. So what are my hit points? 1E and a 2E and a 3E and 4. So it's a 2-beat phrase which loops, you can loop it over 4 beats. So that goes 1E and a 2E and 3E and 4 and 1E and a 2E and, right? Up and 1E and a 2E and 3E and a 4E and 1E and a 2E and, okay? So let's take the E minor chord and try to vibe with the tresillo. And for the purpose of this lesson, I may end up using the shaker just to give you an idea, but actually this is going to be replaced with your left hand playing the root of the chord, in this case E for E minor, G for G major, D for D major, and A for A major. Okay, so you go 1E and 2E and 3. So I'll first play it and then teach you slowly. 1E and a 2E and a 3E. So that's your simple E minor. Now you may argue, doesn't this sound like a triplet? No, this doesn't. This is not a triplet. You're not dividing by 3. You're dividing by 4, but you have these irregular divisions which ends up giving you 3 notes. By playing 3 notes, it doesn't become a triplet, okay? So I've linked up a lot of rhythm videos which I've already talked about in detail. I've talked about triplets, I've compared them. We've also done a little bit of polyrhythms and some fancier stuff. So do check out the rhythm links in the description, okay? So this is the Tresio. So you can do it either LMH, starting from the bottom. New chord, D major, A major. If you're uncomfortable doing all the 4 chords, just take it with 1 chord. That itself will sound awesome. You can also start from the top end, high, middle note, low note. So that'll be change. So Tresio is an incredible rhythm. It just makes everything sound dancey. Okay, so in the left hand, you just hold the roots. 1E, a 2E and a 3. Right, it's also nice and a good responsibility to be able to play the pulse in your left hand while you do the right hand arpeggios. Because the left hand will then complement it well and give you and your listeners a sense of movement. Movement doesn't only come from this pattern, it also comes from the fact that this pattern is played with an incredibly steady and strong pulse. So 1E and a 2E, right? 1E and a 2E and a tak tak dum. You can start from the bottom. So that was about the Tresio. Now let's move forward. The next rhythm, which is really, really important for Latin music and dance music in general, is called as the clave. I'm going to teach you a few of them, but more specifically spend some time on the song clave. The song clave will take the Tresio at these hit points, 1E, a 2E, and a 3E, and a 4. Okay, so you don't copy the Tresio at beats 3 and 4. Instead, you do 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4. And of the 3 and the on of the 4. So, it's also what we call a 3:2 song clave, wherein the first 3 beats are exciting. Da-da-da-ba-ba. And the next 2 is relaxing. So it creates an incredible rhythmic framework. Ba 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 pam pam pa re ra ra pa pa re ra 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 pa ra re re. So I'll count that down for you with the shaker. 1E and a 2E and a starting now. 1E and a 2E and a 3 and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3 and a 4. Bam na. Let's try playing along with me and let's just play along with the E minor chord for now. So we go. Now you could do or. What I'm trying to say is there's any kind of ordering you can do with these notes to make it sound even more different or even more unique. You know, if this rhythm wasn't cool enough, you even have the patterns of the chord notes. So I'm just going to stick with one pattern. Slower. 1E and a 2E and a 3 and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a right and a 3. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E. Now let's do it with the chord changes. D major. Okay, and as always with the bass trying to do the pulse. Pare, parare, bam,
pum pum pare rum pum pum pare rum pum pum pare rum pum pum pare re.
Okay, another thing we do with these claves, now that you got the kind of vibe of a 3-2, you can flip it around and then get a 2-3 vibe. So you could start with what you did at the 3 and a 4 and a, bring it to that, flip it around, and you get something like so 1e and a 2e and a 3e and a 4e and a. So the tresillo starts from the 3. Tresillo, remember, is a 2-beat rhythm. You may like that even better. There's so many things we are able to do with the song clave. We have the 3-2 clave, we have the 2-3 clave, and then you just have the orders of notes itself which you can mess around with. So you go. Right. So common variations which you could look at once you've mastered the tresillo and then the song clave, 3-2 and 2-3, would be just add one note at the end to make it more arpeggio-like. So I'll play it and then show you. Right, so you have three note patterns. One, two, three, one, two, three. It's not a triplet, mind you. It's 1e and a 2e and a 3e and a 4. That would have been song clave. But I'm adding that B, that final note there, which will be at 1e and a 2e and a 3e and a 4e and a. You're adding the and of the 4. So that's a nice rhythm, I guess, customized for an arpeggio phrase. Let's play this along. Keep the pulse in the left hand. 1e and a 2e and a 3 and 1e and a 2, right? Okay, so two more common variations which we have along with the song clave. One will be the bossa clave or the bossa nova clave, which is the same in the first two beats. That's the tresillo copy. Ta, 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 ta. So the second half changes. I'll play it and then show you. 1e and a 2e and a 3e and a 4e. So it's at the E of the 4. Bossa nova clave is used more for like EDM stuff, right? Lot more excitement because of those E's and the E's, which sound a lot more excitable than the ands and of course the on beat, which is rather boring. Okay, and lastly, another variation would be the rumba clave. The rumba clave messes with the tresillo, the first two beats, so that'll be tak ta ta. So 1e and a 2e and a. So the a of the two as opposed to the and of the two, which is what the song clave gave us. So I'll play it and show you. 1e and a 2. 1e and a 2e and a 3 and a 4. And a 4 becomes the same. The shaker. So that was the rumba. So let's recap the entire lesson, guys. What are we trying to do? We are trying to make our arpeggio pattern something as common as this take a very original shape. So we borrow the hit points of the Latin rhythms or the Afro-Cuban rhythms, if you will. We have the tresillo, which is okay. Then we have the song clave. We have the song clave with an addition at the end of the 4. Then we have the bossa clave, the EDM thing. Ah, the rumba. With all of this, as a piano player, it's very important to keep the left hand going. And what better way to keep it going than the pulse, which is definitely for your audience to dance. And that's ultimately what you're trying to do. You're trying to create something unique and memorable in this hand, in the right hand, and you're trying to give the left hand for the audience so that they will move no matter what. And if your left hand can play the pulse with respect to the right hand, this is also an incredible independence training exercise to develop your two hands to sort of work in different ways, right? What better way than the left hand doing the pulse and the right hand doing something really, really different and unique. Again, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. Thanks a ton for watching this lesson. Do help us growing our channel by subscribing if you haven't already, turning on that bell for notifications. Very important. We'll be releasing lessons quite often. And keep rocking. Cheers.